on a joyous spring Saturday evening in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Arena football returns for the Stampede as they play host to the Cedar Rapids River Kings. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us here for SFBN. I'm Chris Marcos, joined by Mike Garland. And Mike, for the first time in a decade, the Stampede back playing arena football, now in the AIF, and the atmosphere here, very, very raucous. This community, so happy to have this team back. What does it mean for the community here in Harrisburg to have the Stampede back here tonight?
Well, first and foremost, Chris, it's affordable family fun. Whenever you can bring moms and dads and families into an arena to cheer on a local sports team, that goes a long way to community supporting community. And the weather in central Pennsylvania has been horrible over the last 5 days, to say the least. It's still chilly. There's high waters on the Susquehanna River. So for folks to be able to come inside and enjoy the arena football and the Harrisburg Stampede, it's a great way to start a weekend.
Talk about the weather, not to mention that earthquake we all went through yesterday. Luckily, everyone okay, but let's focus on this matchup, right? Talk about the community, but two teams out there tonight competitive for the Stampede, first time in action in close to a decade, and this is a team that defensively wants to get things done and make that their identity. A smaller group on the defensive end of the football, but athletic and versatile.
Well, you've always heard the phrase, the defense wins football games. Well, we talked with Coach Noah Tarski earlier in the week, and one of the keys to victory tonight for him, two turnovers and two defensive stops. And his Harrisburg Stampede, they're facing a Cedar Rapids team that's given up 113 points through two games this year. So I think it's reasonable that that Stampede defense may see that success through.
One of the better players on that defense is Matt Hodges, a guy the coaching staff very high on, played his college ball at Norfolk State. He's a guy, athletic, versatile, can play a lot of different positions.
He is a very athletic player, and in the arena game, you need those athletes, the guys that can play multiple positions, the guys that can play both sides of the ball, and Hodges is that guy for Coach Noah Tarski and the Stampede.
On the flip side for the River Kings, you talked briefly about it. Struggled early on defensively, 1-1 on the year, but a big loss to start the season. What are the keys for them tonight?
Yeah, they gave up 87 points in week one. In fact, they're averaging just 24.5 points per game through their two games, conversely giving up 56.5. And in the Arena League, that's a massive points against deficit. So you need points first and foremost. I mean, it goes without saying, you score more points, you win the game. But you have to avoid those mistakes that no doubt yield 87 points. And when you come in facing a team that you've never played before and a team that's playing its first game of the season, you really never know what's going to happen. I know it's cliche, but throw the records out when the River Kings and the Stampede get together.
The stage is set as arena football returns to Harrisburg. We'll take a break. Kickoff next right here on SFBN.
Springtime is the right time to go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get big time selection. Choose from rows and rows of new 2024 Pilots, Accords, Passports, and more. Get big time savings. Drive a new Civic, just $299 a month. Choose from a great selection of Honda CRVs from just $379 a month. It's springtime, so go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get started at FaulknerHonda.com to be sure.
We want to help simplify your life. Belco's checking accounts are easy to use, and most accounts have no minimum balance requirements or monthly service charges. No matter what bells are ringing, you can rely on checking with Belco. Because we believe in every person, every dream, every time. Join today at belco.org or any local branch. Belco Community Credit Union. Believe in better banking.
loving. Push your bum bum. Tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Welcome back in to Pennsylvania's State Farm Show Complex here in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, as we are just about ready for the first game of the 2024 season for the Harrisburg Stampede, playing host to the Cedar Rapids River Kings. Chris Markowitz here alongside Mike Garland as these two teams meet at midfield for the coin toss. And Mike, we'll see who wins the toss, but interesting news going into this one. During our TV timeout after our intro, Caleb Walton, the starting quarterback for the Stampede, helped back to the locker room by his teammates. Looked like he was injured after being introduced in the starting lineup. So his availability in question right now. We'll likely see number 10 Isaac Hurd get the start now at the quarterback spot, but that could be a potential big blow for the Stampede.
There was a lot of pomp and circumstance here in the arena. The hype man playing music, the crowd on their feet as the PA announcer was announcing the starters, and they were doing jumping high fives and chest bumps and whatnot. And then the next thing we know, we look down and Caleb Walton is on the turf here at the arena. And when we talked to Coach Nowotarski a couple of weeks ago, he talked up Walton as being the starter. He played at Lock Haven. He's out of the Lancaster-Mannheim area, and now all of a sudden your game plan is essentially thrown out the window moments before kickoff due to a freak injury to Caleb Walton.
Well, with Walton out, it's the next man up, Isaac Hurd, a quarterback, but he's a versatile player, can play the tailback spot and be spread out at receiver. Listed at 5'11", speedy guy, has decent arm talent. We'll see, though. This is going to be a big obstacle for Coach Nowotarski and the staff, to your point, having to come into game one and change up their opening day offensive strategy. As I believe it was Harrisburg who won the toss, and they will receive first. Harrisburg dressed in their home white jerseys, home blue jerseys, excuse me, with white lettering. And the Cedar Rapids River Kings dressed in their road gray jerseys with black pants and light blue lettering.
You talked about Isaac Hurd. He's from Hawaii. I did a quick look at his Instagram page. Obviously, there's lots to do in Hawaii, and there's pictures of him posed with fish. So he's clearly a successful angler and an athlete. He played at NAIA Southern Oregon University. He was a runner. He was a passer. And today, Coach Nowotarski is going to have to depend on him to take things to the next level against Cedar Rapids, a team that comes in with a couple of games under their belt. So they may be the ones fishing for a big win.
Well, and to your point, too, with Cedar Rapids coming in with a 1-1 record, how much of an advantage does that play for them, knowing that they've got a couple games under their belt already this season?
I think it has to have a lot to do with success, because you can knock off that ring rust, if you will. They got blown out in week one against the Missouri Falcons, 87-14, but then rebounded to beat the Colorado Spartans, 35-26. And by arena standards, 35-26 is a pretty low-scoring game, but regardless, they took their lumps, they got back up off the turf, and came back to pick up a week two win. The Harrisburg Stampede, conversely, playing in their first game of this brand new AIF season, a brand new team, back for the first time in 10 years here at the Pennsylvania State Farm Show Complex. And then all of a sudden, you lose your starting quarterback during pregame introductions.
Yeah, it's a tough way to start the year for Harrisburg, who, by the way, I had it wrong. They will be kicking off to start and it's going to be Joseph Panaccio out of Rider University who will send it away left to right on your screen to begin this contest. Back deep to return for the River Kings, number 2, Tremont Bright, and number 28, Cody Barber.
And now we're going to flip ends of the field as there was some discussion between the officials and the facilities staff. So we're going to reverse skate and we're going to switch things up. And there are so many unique rules to this arena football league that if you are a fan of football, you're going to see a game that looks like football, but it's completely different. For example, if Joe Panaccio can kick off and put it through the uprights just off screen to your left, that's a single point for the Stampede. The River Kings will still have possession, but the Stampede can go up 1-0 based on what would be defined as an uno and a touchback.
Panaccio eyeing to start the season with an uno as 2024 is underway and arena football returns to Harrisburg. Kick received by Barber. Room to run. Midfield, spun out across the 20, finally taken down by Howard Holton, who gets the first tackle of the season. And it's good field position to start for Cedar Rapids.
A nice seam on that return, bringing the ball up to about the 20-yard line. And from what I understand, as we piece these rules together throughout the broadcast, it will generally be a running clock. And the teams and their respective benches are actually in the end zones here at this complex.
Taking it all in, very different from the traditional game, but should be a up-pace, high-tempo, high-scoring affair.
Three offensive linemen, of course, the quarterback and a back in the backfield, three wide receivers for Cedar Rapids, and the receivers can be in motion.
Flanagan goes in motion and is the first man to catch a pass tonight, about a 5-yard gain. Kaylor Sullivan, the 6'3 quarterback out of Midwestern State, starts his day 1-for-1.
You still need 10 yards to get a first down. The sticks are positioned on the far side of the field, spanning the 20s. Midfield is the 25 in this game, so that was a gain of about 5 yards. It's going to bring up second down and 5 for Cedar Rapids.
Sullivan spread out to the left now. In motion goes Verlin Reed. Deep pass, Reed open but underthrown. Sullivan had him in the corner, got it out late and left it short.
And that pass was about 3 yards short. Something else unique about this game, as we scan the field, you see the two head coaches, Bernie Nowotarski for the Harrisburg Stampede and Jerron Clark for Cedar Rapids. They're each standing behind the Cedar Rapids offense. It reminds me of a high school football scrimmage or Smurf football where the coaches are out there still working with the kids and working with the players firsthand.
So third down and 5 now for Cedar Rapids. As Harrisburg looking for a big stop, fake handoff, it's a keeper. Sullivan with room to run, pushed against the boards as he picks up a big first down, showing off the dual strength as a quarterback.
Nice play action as well, as he read the defense, kept the ball himself, and you're not going to see a ton of running in this indoor game. You can take a look at it one more time. He pulled the ball back out of the breadbasket and advanced it past midfield and into the proverbial red zone. The ball spotted at about the 13-yard line.
12-yard carry as the River Kings are knocking on the door here. Two men go in motion. Throw to the end zone, nearly intercepted. Joshua Holly dropped back in coverage. The linebacker out of Morgan State with a big play.
That was a big play, and it may have been tipped at the line of scrimmage as well. Regardless, knocked down at the second level for the Harrisburg Stampede, and Josh Holly, one of the captains. He's a math teacher, by the way, by trade, works in Baltimore, so that adds up to second down.
Holly, gotta be one of those fan favorites. This is a guy who, to your point, making a decent commute to be here and just loves this game. Coach was raving about him a week ago when we met him to talk about his prospects for the season. Two men in motion here for the River Kings. This throw off target by Sullivan, who's now 1-for-4 through the air. Third and 10 coming up for Cedar Rapids.
A running clock thus far, and you'll only see stoppages in the last 2 or 1 minute of the respective quarters. It varies. It stops, I believe, under 2 minutes in the second and fourth quarters and under a minute in the first and third quarters. Like I said, it looks a lot like football, but it's a whole lot different.
Yeah, we confirmed all that with our officials, who will give you their names in just a second here. Big third down for Cedar Rapids, facing a third and 10. Sullivan with time, wants the end zone, and he has a touchdown. Verlin Reed into the end zone as the River Kings take an early lead.
Well, he fired that pass into the corner, and Verlin Reed was able to hold on to it. Verlin Reed played quarterback at Findlay. He was the 2017 IFL Rookie of the Year, and this time around he is catching passes as he snuck into the end zone for the first points of the night for Cedar Rapids.
And it looks like Cedar Rapids will line up for the extra point. You can fake it if you'd like on a field goal attempt.
You can drop kick it if you'd like to.
Instead, they go for it here, and it's wide left. Hits the left post, no good.
Pressure by Issa Daria. He came in off the left side of the offensive line. May have gotten a finger on it. Plus, it was a wobbly, lackadaisical snap back to the holder. So the timing of all of this was just off. And you can see here on the replay, the snap is just kind of lobbed back there, end over end, if you will. And Daria right there in the face of the kick. So still a touchdown, missed extra point. And in this game, points are important.
So Cedar Rapids goes 30 yards on their opening drive for the score. Unable to connect on the extra point, however, as they lead 6-0 with 10 minutes and 2 seconds remaining here in quarter number one. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, the Stampede had an opportunity for a turnover there. Holly just missed an opportunity, not just for an interception, but perhaps a pick six. And talking with Coach Noah Tarski coming into today, he said, look, we've got to get two stops and two turnovers. That was a missed chance for the first one of the day.
Absolutely, and that missed turnover becomes points for Cedar Rapids. But the Harrisburg offense hasn't even been on the field yet, so an opportunity forthcoming for the blue and white, the blue and yellow, if you will. They're blue, white, and yellow to come right back down the field and answer, and you're going to do it now with a backup quarterback.
Marcus Taylor back deep to return, the receiver from Norfolk State University. Patrick Gorman also back there about 15 yards in front of him. Taylor fields it into the end zone. Up the middle, wrapped up just shy of the 10-yard line. And that is where the Stampede will begin their 2024 campaign on offense. And we will get our first look at Isaac Hurd.
It was Austin Wood on the tackle for Cedar Rapids. He did a great job busting downfield, staying in his lane, and making that tackle. And if you look at starting field position for the Stampede versus starting field position for what Cedar Rapids has, stark contrast here for Harrisburg.
Clock rolling, 9 minutes, 22 seconds, and counting in quarter number one. Hurd comes out, looks like in a shotgun set. Giovanni Franklin in the backfield. The big fella, around 260 pounds. Two men in motion, high snap. Hurd will keep it. Tries to break a tackle, but wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. Darius Arrington, excellent play there, allowing no gain.
And it was a high shotgun snap. This is a passing first league, and I know we're gonna talk about it 100 times tonight. You get the injury to the starting quarterback, Caleb Walton. All of a sudden, Isaac Hurd has to come in with really no advance notice, and the first play of the game is almost a busted play.
Second and 10, another high snap. Hurd back near the end zone, throws far sideline, short gain, as it's Aaron Brown, the tight end from Moravian, fighting for a couple extra yards there. Got about 4 yards on the completion, third and 6 coming up.
He did a great job hauling that one in and turning upfield to try to pick up a couple of extra yards. And Cedar Rapids had a third down and 5 on their first drive. This is a third down and 6, still very makeable down and distance Cedar Rapids was able to convert on a quarterback sneak on a fake inside handoff.
So third and six, Hurd hasn't had a lot of time to throw, and Coach Nowotarski told us, you get about 2.4 seconds on average in this league to get rid of the ball. Another high snap, this one over Hurd's head, into the end zone, flags fly. This will be likely a safety. We'll see what the penalty flags are for. With that play, doomed from the beginning for Harrisburg.
It was doomed. That's at least the second high shotgun snap. I will say that the left side of the Cedar Rapids defensive line was in the neutral zone, so Harrisburg may dodge a bullet here, although we'll see. It is encroachment on the defense, so that will scrub the safety, and it should give Harrisburg 5 yards, so third down and one following the offsides penalty.
Yeah, so Harrisburg catches a big break there, but I think the concern early on here, Mike, three high snaps. Stampede really need to clean that up right now.
To say the least. And there's a nice crowd here tonight. You want to give the home fans something to cheer about. And even though this is the first possession for the Harrisburg Stampede, so far it's been challenging.
7 minutes, 36 seconds and rolling in quarter number one. Third and one for Harrisburg.
Now a false start on the right side of the line, so the 5 yards they gained, they give back. The only difference is those 2 points come off the board.
And you have to wonder, with this sloppy start offensively, how much of a factor losing Walton in warm-ups is. These players on the field, look, obviously they've gone through camp together, but still trying to gel as a unit, playing against the Cedar Rapids team that has 2 games under their belt already.
Harrisburg taking a lot of time in the huddle. The center is Casey Pierce. He's from Shippensburg. So certainly not the first time he's played center, but has struggled early on.
On third and six, deep ball, end zone, touchdown! Todd Simmons on a huge strike as Isaac Hurd gets the crowd going here in Harrisburg.
I don't know what you're talking about. Offsides penalty? Eh. Perfect. Beautiful pass by Hurd. The shotgun snap still just a snitch high, but he was able to pull it down and find his man in motion and connect in stride. Caught it at the front of the end zone. Momentum carried it into the back dasher boards. 4-6, and now the go-ahead extra point pending from the foot of Joe Peduccio.
36 yards through the air, Hurd to Simmons. Good snap, good hold, and it's through. Harrisburg with its first lead of the season after a thrilling 36-yard touchdown on a third and six. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, sloppy start on the first couple plays for the Stampede, but when he's had time, Isaac Hurd has shown he could be on the money.
It's amazing to think that each team has had one offensive drive, each team has scored a touchdown, but the way that it happened, I'm not sure it could be more different. Cedar Rapids went right down the field. Harrisburg started deep in their own territory, went forwards, went backwards, couldn't get out of their own way, and all of a sudden, all is fixed on a long touchdown bomb from Hurd to Simmons.
And the crowd really getting into it now. Got a decent crowd here for the opener. These fans excited to see arena football back for the first time in a decade. This is a proud franchise. Won a championship back in 2013, and you know, Coach Nowotarski a part of that. And they're trying to return to glory now in the AIF. We'll take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the Harrisburg Stampede on SFPN. The Stampede set to kick off right to left on your screen after taking a 7-6 lead on a 36-yard touchdown strike from Isaac Hurd to Todd Simmons. First touchdown of the year for Harrisburg. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, you made the point before we went to break. Both teams score a touchdown on their opening drive, but it couldn't have been in more polar opposite fashions.
It was pretty for one team, challenging for another. The end result is the same.
Barber on the return. He goes up the middle. Across the 15, still going. Across the 20, finally taken down by Matt Hodges, our player to watch. But something to keep an early eye on, Cedar Rapids and their ability to get good field position off returns. Twice now they've gotten at least to the 20-yard line.
Their second kick return, their second 20-plus yard return. And in this 50-yard war on the floor, when you can cut the field in half right out of the gate on a kickoff return, you're going a long way to putting points on the board with ease.
First and 10 for the River Kings from their own 22-yard line. And their opening drive featured Kaylor Sullivan methodically working his team up the field. He went 2 for 5 through the air, but had a big 13-yard scamper to pick up a first down, and then threw a touchdown pass to Verlin Reed in the red zone.
His quarterback keeper was probably the play of that opening drive other than the touchdown itself.
Two in motion for Cedar Rapids. Short pass left sideline. This is going to be a big gain. Broken tackle. And finally forced out of bounds at the 10-yard line is Robert Major, 6'3 receiver out of Avila University.
Now you can play off the dasher boards to a point. If you're a receiver, you catch the ball, you bump into the wall, you can keep going. If you're pushed into the wall, now you're down.
18-yard reception for Major. And Cedar Rapids quickly knocking on the door once again. First and goal from the Harrisburg 10-yard line.
Just the second play from scrimmage on this drive.
Reed goes in motion. It's a pitch right. Bright, thrown to the turf. A sea of blue got there to bring him down, led by Joshua Holly.
Matt Hodges there as well, our player to watch. Coach Toasty told us he can play linebacker, he can play defensive back. He is a real athlete, and you see that contact right there. That's the first big hit of the game that we've seen.
Coach Nowotarski told us, look, we're a smaller unit defensively, but our speed, particularly getting to the edges, is our strength. You saw it on display there. Johnson in motion. Another pitch right, and this goes for a loss. Hodges gets it to him in the backfield. Lost a 2 on the play, and Matt Hodges with the biggest play defensively so far for Harrisburg.
Back-to-back big plays for Matt Hodges, and he is flexing his young man muscles both to the fans on the sideline and to his teammates in the huddle.
Third down and goal from the Harrisburg 12-yard line. The Stampede able to stifle back-to-back rushing attempts from the River Kings. And who do they go to here? Likely will be a passing play. Flanagan slot left. Johnson in motion. Left corner, Johnson against the boards. Touchdown.
He beat Jeremy Lewis and Howard Holton. Split those two defenders for the second score of the night for the Cedar Rapids River Kings. And you can see man in motion and then cuts left. It's an out and it's a score.
Sullivan's been impressive so far. 7 pass attempts, 4 completions, but in a smaller field in the red zone, he's made the throws to tight spots in the corner of the end zone. One on the left side here to Johnson, the other one to Reed on the opening drive. Impressive stuff from him so far. Kick is up, and this time it's through for Cedar Rapids, who takes a 13-7 lead. With 2:13 left to play in the opening quarter, Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, we saw Harrisburg make some nice plays when the River Kings went to the ground attack, but right now the Stampede haven't had an answer for the River Kings when they've gone to the air.
They haven't had an answer going to the air, and the other thing that has really hurt them is their kick coverage. Cedar Rapids has been able to cut the field in half with big kickoff returns. And I mentioned at the beginning of this drive, when you're starting your drive on a 50-yard field from midfield, literally the game has been cut in half.
Back deep to return for Harrisburg will be Marcus Taylor.
A nice crowd here tonight at the Pennsylvania State Farm Show Complex. I know that owner Justin Cobble has really engaged the community, different groups, organizations. He wants the team to be out in the community, and he wants the community to be here supporting the team. And so far, the synergy is there.
A great atmosphere here for the season opener. Short kick as Taylor, with room to run, has the space, brought down just a yard shy of the 20, and he was one cut away from potentially taking that to the house.
He received that ball, and that first step looked like he was shot out of a rocket ship, and he got to about the 15, cut right, as you can see. He fields at the 6, gets to the 15, then to the 20, cuts right, and meets two Cedar Rapids defenders who plants him at the 19. So the second possession for the Stampede, and it was in this area where they had a false start penalty on the last drive, and then following that false start, it was a 30-plus yard touchdown pass.
Second drive tonight for Isaac Hurd and the Stampede. He's 2 for 2. He's thrown for 40 yards and a touchdown. Harrisburg on their own 19. Hurd, quick pass over the middle, short gain. It's Patrick Dorman, came out of the slot in motion, and he picks up 3 dangerous yards going over the middle. But he's a tough man in that slot receiver position.
And Darius Arrington with the tackle. Arrington from Central State University. And he was right on that catch. The quick hitter, and the defensive back was there to make the contact, giving up just 2 yards on first down.
Second and 7. Harrisburg on their own 22. Hurd with time. Over the middle, complete. Gorman breaks a tackle, wrapped up at the 15. Touchdown saving play there by Austin Wood, but Gorman with another nice catch over the middle.
When Coach Nowotarski told us that you need 2.4 seconds or less to be able to complete a pass, you watch this snap, and it feels like Hurd is in the pocket forever. There was almost a pump fake there as well. So a nice job of the protection from his offensive line. The trio up front really held firm.
15-yard gain on the reception. First and 10 for Harrisburg, this time from the 12-yard line of their opponent. This pass off target, intended for Aaron Brown. First incomplete pass thrown tonight by Hurd.
And the first quarter comes to an end. It's been action-packed for sure, Chris, and Harrisburg threatening and hoping to score and take the lead.
Up-tempo football here in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. We'll take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the Harrisburg Stampede on SFBN. Second quarter about to start in a quickly moving season opener for the Harrisburg Stampede, who trail the Cedar Rapids River Kings 13-7. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Harrisburg with a second down. As two men go in motion, second and 10, Hurd rolls out right, under pressure, nearly fumbles the football, gets it shoveled out of bounds. It did not get back to the line of scrimmage.
It did not, although the lady in the black hoodie leaning against the dasher boards, I'm not sure she's an eligible receiver, but she was definitely in the area.
One more look here.
Heard under pressure. He's scrambling hard right, stiff arm, fumbles the ball, and then look, lady, let catch it. Lady, come on. You get the good seat, you got to catch the ball.
Cedar Rapids now pleading their case. They want a penalty for intentional grounding. The officials deliberating here.
That is referee Michael Davis. Your officials are Michael Davis, Aaron Jamin, Joe Letizia, Shane Gemmel, and Steve Kinney. They were gracious enough to give me a fancy little card that has their names on it and everything. Lucky us.
Making it easy for us here tonight.
I walked down some steps and I saw some guys and I thought, those guys look like officials. Let me walk over and talk to them. And I'm not sure if they were more offended than I thought they looked like officials or what. I mean, wait, what do you mean we look like officials? We're in street clothes, man.
Spot foul as Harrisburg will have it on the Cedar Rapids 20-yard line. So this is a third down and 18. High snap again. Heard pitches right. Nowhere for Giovanni Franklin to go. He may have lost a couple yards.
And that is a big man to be running the ball on third down and 18. Giovanni Franklin went to Boise State University, played rugby there. And oh, by the way, as you can see, he takes this pitch, another high shotgun snap, and that disrupts the play. Then you pitch it to him, and there's two big defensive linemen there to bring him down. That's a scrum and a half. And oh, by the way, Franklin is from Anchorage, Alaska, some 4,231 miles from this very facility.
Fourth down and 23 here. Harrisburg leaves the offense on the turf.
There is no punting in the Arena League, so unless you're going to line up for a long field goal, you go for it.
High snap again. Heard with time, rolls right, looking to throw. End zone, left it short. Had Gorman, who was a couple yards shy of the end zone. But a big stop there for the River Kings, already leading by 6 points.
And again, Cedar Rapids gets great field position to start their third drive of the game. Heard rolling to his right, and whether the pass was intended for Patrick Gorman or Aaron Brown, regardless, it falls short. And if it was going to Brown, it was way short of the line to gain anyway.
Brown had room to run after the catch, but to your point, it would have been short of the end zone. It would have been a close play. So the River Kings with the first stop of the night, and excellent field position for them once again. Kaylor Sullivan, who has played well, he's 4 for 7 tonight with 2 touchdown passes, lines up in the gun. Bad snap, somehow tipped to the tailback. Tremont Bright scampers forward for 4 yards, and now flags fly away from the football.
Some extracurriculars between Cedar Rapids and Harrisburg, but what just happened there, Chris, is sort of the epitome of the way this game has gone for Cedar Rapids and for Harrisburg. Shotgun snaps like that for Harrisburg disrupt the offense. For Cedar Rapids, it's a gain of 6.
They get Howard Holton with a personal foul after it as well. And one more look here. Look, it's a bad snap, but Sullivan just tips it right to Bright.
As if that's how they drew it up. And then you can see actually at the top of the screen on the back end of the replay, Holton going hands to the face on the Cedar Rapids player. And at any level, that'll draw a flag plus 15.
So after the penalty, it's a first and 10 from the Harrisburg 12 for Cedar Rapids. Sullivan in the gun. Sullivan met in the backfield and sacked by Joshua Holly, who continues to put his fingerprints all over this game defensively.
Joshua Holly from Morgan State University came together with Kaylor Sullivan as if to ask him if he wanted to go to the neighboring alpaca show.
Holly's made a number of key plays defensively. One more look here.
He has played well tonight. Untouched, the back out of the backfield, missed the block, And I'm not sure that was going to be a favorable matchup either way.
Second and 13, Enzo shot. Some contact, and that's a pass interference call, likely against Harrisburg, as Flanagan was held in the end zone.
Anelio Pena in the area out of Shepherd University in West Virginia, and he was draped all over Shiloh Flanagan.
Officials will talk this over, and we'll wait for the decision. One more look here.
You get the Ram and the Coyote coming together in the corner. And I don't know how that fight plays out in the wild, but here the Zebra actually wins.
And it's a 10-yard penalty that advances Cedar Rapids even closer to the end zone. Mike, this River Kings offense has been composed and has found the holes consistently against Harrisburg. Sullivan, impressive. Very, very poised right now at the quarterback position.
Very poised, to say the least. And their offense just can't do any wrong. Meanwhile, Harrisburg can't get out of their own way. And it all started with that pregame injury to quarterback Caleb Walton.
Running play here goes nowhere. Hodges, first man on the tackle. Daria came in as well. And that goes for a loss of two.
Matt Hodges has been here, there, and everywhere. He's a modern-day Roy Kent. Minus a couple of syllables.
One more look here. That play doomed from the start.
He busted in there, made the tackle. Hodges joined by Issa Daria out of Waldorf University.
He's here, he's there, he's everywhere. That's what you'd say, right?
Everywhere. Is that what we're doing? Okay.
That's how we'll keep it family friendly here tonight in Harrisburg. Second down and goal now for Cedar Rapids from the Harrisburg 7. High snap, and it's a loose ball in the backfield. Sullivan does a good job there to fall on it and prevents a turnover.
I've seen that play before. This time for Cedar Rapids, it's a big loss. Still trying to capitalize on that pass interference penalty, but now going backwards. Third down and goal. And a high shotgun snap from center Douglas Tucker out of Walsh University. And again, it's Hodges getting credit for the tackle. He has come on like a house of fire, but he is as advertised thus far.
A loss of 10 yards, now third down and goal from the 18. Another bad snap. Sullivan with time though, open man, end zone, touchdown. Donovan Johnson lost in coverage. And the River Kings come back with their third score of the night.
Donovan Johnson from Concordia St. Paul University snags his first touchdown. And Sullivan corrals that shotgun snap and then finds Johnson wide open in the end zone. He beat Emilio Pena, who had been flagged for that pass interference penalty just a couple of plays ago. So now Cedar Rapids looking to go up by two scores with this extra point.
Good snap, and it is through. Cedar Rapids ahead 20-7 with 8:40 remaining in the first half. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, the difference in this game so far, both teams have had some mistakes, some errant snaps, a couple loose balls, but Harrisburg not getting the lucky bounces. Cedar Rapids seeing things go their way.
Cedar Rapids certainly has seen the benefit of a couple of fortunate bounces. Really, the only thing that hasn't gone right for the River Kings was that first extra point. Otherwise, they've managed successful kickoff returns. They've had an errant shotgun snap fall right into the hands of a running back who advanced it. They've been benefiting from penalties. So they really are, they're clicking and they're lucky.
Coach Noah Tarski with a long conversation now with his return team. And you have to wonder what he's talking about with them. They have struggled to get the ball out to quality position consistently. The last time they received the kick, though, it was a very good return, as we saw Taylor get to about the 18-yard line, had some room to run.
We'll see if he can do it again. And, you know, Chris, you look around this arena, it serves many purposes. The Harrisburg Heat indoor soccer team play here. They just wrapped up their regular season, and you have a nice crowd out here tonight. We talked about it during pregame. Families, the community coming out. I see people of all ages and demographic here at the arena tonight, and ownership has to love that. And I hope the fans enjoy the product on the field, win or lose. You have to be entertained by what you're seeing.
Taylor back deep to return. Line drive kick fielded by Gorman at his own five. Room to run. He's in midfield. Still going. Gorman across the 20 and down at the 15. Patrick Gorman with an electric return.
And a late flag, and Harrisburg will benefit some extracurriculars from Cedar Rapids, and just a boneheaded play by one of the River Kings players to grab face mask, twist. Great.
One more look here. Gorman had it all the way.
It was a low line drive kickoff, which he fielded and advanced into the 15-yard line area. And then again, some pushing and shoving. And you get that extra penalty at the end. I just never understood it. At any level of football, an act like that is selfish. It is not a team-first type of mentality. It's a me-first. It's I'm not going to let you show me up regardless of what my actions do to my team.
Well, and after the penalty, golden opportunity here for Harrisburg. They have a first and goal from the River Kings' 7.5-yard marker.
And the best starting field position of the night, to say the least, for the Harrisburg Stampede and quarterback Isaac Hurd.
Hurd 4-for-6 tonight. Bad snap, he comes down with it though. Room to run, Hurd up the middle and knocked down, hit hard at the 2-yard line. But he turns a broken play into a 5-yard gain.
Hurd was thundering forward there, and I saw off screen, and you can see another bad shotgun snap. He follows the lead blocker there. It was actually Giovanni Franklin that became the fullback along the way. But I've seen quarterback center exchange practice off screen multiple times, or off field, I should say, and it's just not translating here in real life between Casey Pierce and Isaac Hurd.
Hurd brings down another high snap. He'll run for the end zone, spin in for a touchdown. Isaac Hurd runs in for his first rushing score of the season, and it's a one-score contest.
He's thrown a touchdown, he's caught a touchdown, and on to kick the extra point is Joe Panuccio. And you can see the shotgun snap still high. He steps up in the pocket and then cuts across the five and spins into the end zone. Kind of one of those, the heck with it, I'll do it myself type of plays.
And give Hurd a lot of credit. Not slated to be the starting quarterback here in the season opener for Harrisburg, but he has played as if he's the starter. A touchdown through the air, a touchdown on the ground. Extra point is up, and it is no good. This remains a 7-point contest. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, we talked briefly about what Harrisburg was struggling with, inconsistency on returns. They got a huge boost, though, from Patrick Gorman, who took the ball to the 15-yard line, got a penalty, and then Hurd followed it up with a touchdown. We'll take a break. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Harrisburg Stampede Football on SFBN. Harrisburg trails Cedar Rapids 20-13 with 6:29 remaining in quarter number two. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, both offenses have had some highlight moments to start in this game, but the major difference right now, the Stampede stopped once by the River Kings, and Cedar Rapids hasn't been stopped offensively. They're about to receive the ball for the fourth time tonight. And defensively, what does Harrisburg have to do to try to get the River Kings off the field for the first time tonight?
Well, you've got to make the tackles, and it all starts right here on this kickoff return. If they push it past the 20, you're behind the eight ball again.
Barber hit hard. His helmet flies off, and a penalty flag quick to come out, as it's going to be Hodges guilty of the unnecessary roughness call here.
It was a bit of a clothesline. And right there, it happened as I was saying, you have to make the tackle. They actually call a block in the back, so it's not on the tackle, it's on a block in the back. So this will be the worst starting field position of the game for Cedar Rapids.
Yeah, my apologies. Whenever you see a return man's helmet fly off and a penalty flag going with it, I just jumped to the assumption that was on the defense, but great play there by Hodges on replay. And the River Kings playing in the shadows of their own goalposts right now. Bad snap, and this play doomed from the start. Penalty flags fly.
I guess they can only go back a couple of feet.
It's going to be a false start.
So that half the distance stuff, that's one of those things that I would argue they're at the six. No, you jumped offside. That's 5 yards. Back to the one.
I'm with you on that one.
If you can march it off, you should.
I'm also a advocate for holding penalties being spot fouls versus losses of 10, but that's a conversation for another day.
I'm a real big get off my lawn kind of guy. Some of my friends would call me a curmudgeon, so, you know, there are many things in this world that grind my gears.
High snap on first down. Sullivan fires over the middle, nearly intercepted, as it was Howard Holton who read that the whole way.
We almost saw that first turnover that Coach Nowotarski's been asking for.
And that's twice now that the Stampede have come inches away from an interception.
You can see the pressure as well with Sullivan throwing out of his own end zone.
Holton had a good read on it. Sullivan, not much time to throw, and perhaps his receiver broke for the go route instead of the post route. Miscommunication there. Second down and 13, high snap, could be a safety here, and it is! Matt Hodges brings down Sullivan, and that's the first stop for the Stampede.
That's both a defensive stop and a turnover, and points. That's a wild card scenario that Coach Nowotarski didn't talk about. Never did he say, we want a defensive stop, a turnover, and some points. All happened on the same play.
And errant snaps becoming a theme in this contest now. We have seen both offenses struggle in that department. The safety makes it a 20-15 contest. Harrisburg trailing in the affair with 4:43 remaining in the second quarter. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, these two teams really need to clean up their center play right now.
Yeah, that has probably been the weakest link for both teams tonight. We've seen it all game long for Harrisburg, and we've recently started to see it for Cedar Rapids. It was something that we did not see on their first three drives, or at least the first two. Then on the back end of the third and all throughout the fourth drive here, it's been high snaps from the center. So a new possession for Harrisburg as well. They get the 2 points, plus they'll get the ball on this upcoming free kick.
Give credit to Matt Hodges. His tackle on the opening kickoff there for that drive set the tone. And for the first time tonight, the River Kings were playing close to their own end zone. Perhaps that turned the pressure up a little bit for them offensively.
They certainly felt the squeeze, and it became 2 points for Harrisburg. So it's a make and take it scenario. Points for the Stampede and possession. Now a squib kick.
Taylor fields it at the six. Taylor across the 15 and stops short just shy of the 20. Fans were groaning as Patrick Gorman was tossed against the boards. They wanted a penalty flag, didn't get it.
Well, Olajuwon Smith brought the wood on that kick coverage. And you can hear the audible ooh from the audience. And right here it is. He blew him up. But luckily, Patrick Gorman hopped up, the wide receiver from Stevenson University. And he is on the field for this first down and 10.
Harrisburg already playing a man down with Walton being injured in introductions. And only 21 players on each roster. Penalty flag here. We'll see if this play holds as it's a scamper by Hurd for about 5 yards.
Hurd gave himself up on that play as well, so probably knowing a little bit of something there.
Looks like it will be coming back. Oh, no. Wise decision there by Isaac Hurd, who could have fought for the extra yard to make it a 5-yard gain, but instead, knowing the penalty flag was in his favor, gave himself up, and it's a 1st and 5 now after the illegal defensive formation.
Hey, people are getting hurt slapping high fives in pregame. Why risk it on a first down run?
Harrisburg can ill afford an injury to their backup quarterback right now. I'm not even sure who would take the snaps if Hurd were to have to take a couple plays off right now.
Yeah, I couldn't even begin to guess.
Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, so far this contest living up to the hype. Fun action back and forth here in the season opener for Harrisburg. Got off to a sloppy start offensively, but it looks like the Stampede have cleaned things up and are in a good rhythm towards the tail end of the second quarter.
They have 3 minutes and 40 seconds to put some more points on the board. Now an official's stoppage. It's been a rather rapidly moving first half other than these unexplained stoppages. It's going to be first down and short following the penalty. First down and 5. Possibly, nope, it's going to be 1st and 10 as they move the down and distance sticks. In this league, they do have the chains, but they have no chain men, if you will, although there are 3 guys who will now be behind the play.
Hurd rolls right, airs it out, end zone short. Intended for Gorman, a dangerous throw across the field. Darius Arrington had a good beat on it, but fortunately it was short for an incomplete pass.
Hurd found himself scrambling to the right and trying to throw back across his body, and at any level of football, the science of that just does not MacGyver under most scenarios, and that pass fell short. And he threw off his back foot.
Second down coming up, a yard shy of midfield. The football with the Stampede, who trail by 5. Clock rolling, under 3 minutes remaining in the first half.
The drum line here at the arena making some noise, trying to get the fans hyped.
Hurd with time, throws over the middle, intercepted! A flag is down, so hold everything. But right now, Barber returning the pick to the end zone. It's a touchdown for now, but let's see what the flag is for.
The first offensive turnover for the Stampede. And for the moment, it results in 6 for Cedar Rapids, but we'll wait for the call from referee Michael Davis. So the 6 points come off the board. The Stampede dodge a bullet, and they'll have the ball back 1st down and 10. They called illegal defense. You can see that interception from Hurd. He threw into double coverage. And it was returned for 6. But again, the penalty erases that touchdown and gives Harrisburg a 1st down and 10. Now at the 21-yard line. And the Stampede have advanced into Cedar Rapids territory by way of 2 penalties.
Yeah, Harrisburg catching a big break there as that had the opportunity for Cedar Rapids to blow this game open in the first half. 2:10 and counting here in the second quarter. Clock is rolling. Hurd in the gun. Time. End zone. Incomplete. He had Aaron Brown open on the fade route, but the throw just a bit too far towards the sideline and out of bounds.
Pass was just a little bit high, just a little bit wide, and Aaron Brown listed as a tight end for Moravian, but also doesn't look like the type of receiver that's going to jump out of the arena to catch a ball that's a little high. And he was battling there with Austin Wood,
And for Harrisburg right now, this is an interesting point in the contest, Mike, because they want to score, but they also want to leave as little time on the clock as possible. As Hurd takes the snap on second and 10, throws short, this one complete for Brown, got about 5 yards on the completion, and a timeout taken here with exactly 60 seconds to play in the half. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland.
You mentioned not leaving time on the clock. It's absolutely right. You can literally score on one play in this league. You have a kicker with a decent leg in Joe Panuccio, but why settle for three if you can pick up six? And we mentioned earlier about Josh Holly being a math teacher. Well, Joe Panuccio is a high school soccer coach at nearby Mechanicsburg High School. I had a Freudian slip earlier when I said Coach Panuccio. I wasn't wrong. I just wasn't right in the moment.
Well, that soccer leg paying dividends for him here in the AIF, as on third and 5, pass caught close sideline by Simmons. And does he have enough? The officials indicating yes. He got 7 yards, and they'll move the chains. That keeps the clock rolling here, 42 seconds and counting in the second quarter.
Stampede not showing a big sense of urgency here. Simmons already has one touchdown catch and does a nice job moving the chains this time around.
So the clock rolling right now. Hurd in the gun. It's a keeper. He sprints left and dives forward for an extra couple yards. Second and goal from the 5 coming up briefly, and now the clock pauses with 17 seconds remaining in the half. So the Stampede playing this one well here, Mike, as they'll have a couple shots at the end zone without giving the River Kings too much time to respond.
If Harrisburg does this right, the Cedar Rapids offense does not come back on the field.
And this would be huge for Harrisburg, trailing pretty much the entire first half to take a late lead going into the locker room, because they also receive the kickoff to start the third quarter.
It's a good opportunity to do something good now while you can. And Harrisburg has one timeout left. With about a 20-minute halftime break coming up, a couple of ceremonies, retirement ceremonies, if you will, for former Stampede players, some names that longtime Stampede fans would recognize. That's coming up at halftime, and I'm sure we'll offer a live look-in at that, and then we'll come back for the second half of this game. And if you are looking for more Harrisburg Stampede action, certainly want to check them out on their website, which is hbgstampede.com. You can check out their schedule, promotional activities, and more. They have some big names as special guests coming to games this year. So again, hbgstampede.com.
Second and goal, Hurd, end zone incomplete, but a flag is down. And if it's on the Cedar Rapids River Kings, this would be their third of the drive.
It has been a challenging drive. And the penalty is against Cedar Rapids. Dwayne Stewart from Siena Heights University. Dwayne Stewart, a big boy in there, Chris. 6'4", 3'10".
Big fella, but guilty of a big penalty, as it's first and goal. Check that, second and goal. They do reset it to a first and goal after the penalty.
This is at least the third first down Harrisburg has gotten by way of Cedar Rapids penalty.
The Stampede with a golden opportunity to take a lead into the locker room at the half.
One timeout left, good time for a quarterback draw.
Hurd, fade, corner end zone, touchdown! Aaron Brown hauls it in against the boards, and Harrisburg takes their first lead of the day.
That works as well. Brown may have gotten away with a little bit of a push-off. He was an intended receiver on a pass earlier in this drive. This time around, he corrals it 4-6. Hurd takes that snap, one step drop, and right in the face of Deacon Schumann from Concordia St. Paul University. First touchdown catch of the season for Aaron Brown. Second touchdown of the night for Isaac Hurd. The other was by way of his feet.
Now Panuccio on for the extra point. Flag flies, kick is up and good. what hold everything. And it's another penalty against the River Kings. They're fourth on the drive. Illegal defense to call yet again.
Likely a penalty that gets enforced on the kickoff, and it might be an opportunity for the Stampede and Panuccio to get that elusive single, the uno, if you will, because if this penalty gets enforced on the kickoff in any way and you push the kick line up from the goal line to maybe the five, Panuccio can put it through the uprights for a single point. We'll see where they spot this ball on the kick.
seconds remaining in the half. Harrisburg lining up for the kickoff, so we'll see what they do here after the penalty. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, Harrisburg stumbled out of the gate. They saw their starting quarterback injured during introductions. Offense was sputtering to begin, but they've cleaned things up, got a big safety, have taken a lead late here. And if you are Coach Noah Tarski right now, what are you saying to your team at the half based on the performance through 30 minutes of play so far?
I mean, I think you talk to your defense and you tell them to stay the course. The defense is actually playing very well. If you're talking to the offense, you need to work on those quarterback center exchanges, because you continue to play with fire, Scarecrow, you're going to get burned eventually. And right now, with Harrisburg having its first lead of the game, you don't want to give up anything crazy.
This kick goes into the River Kings end zone, fielded by Carey, who goes up the middle, wrapped up at about his own 14-yard line. 4 seconds remaining in the half.
Not a ton of time ran off the clock on that kick return. So Cedar Rapids will have at least one play, but they do have all three timeouts. So maybe one or two plays before the teams head to their respective locker rooms here.
Yeah, they can throw it short for about a 5-yard gain, go to a knee, take a timeout. If not, it's a 36-yard attempt to the end zone. Defense! Sullivan has plenty of arm to get it there. Defense! Sullivan with the snap, flags fly, this play blown dead as Sullivan thrown to the turf, and he plays dead for a second there, maybe trying to draw an unnecessary roughness call. You like the sportsmanship, or the gamesmanship, I should say. But it's a false start nonetheless against the River Kings, which makes this even more difficult for them to score a touchdown.
Well, we don't have any kind of official stats, but from a penalties standpoint, the River Kings are winning a category that they certainly don't want to be winning. They have the most penalties for the most yards.
First and 15 for Cedar Rapids, but that doesn't really matter. They're going end zone here with 2.9 seconds to play in the half.
Well, and that false start should have been dead ball, so I'll be interested to see if they put any time back on the clock or if they'll just leave it at 2.9. And they're going to leave the clock at 2.9, so this should be the final play of the quarter.
Sullivan. Ball loose, flag flies. Is this a touchdown? It is! Touchdown Harrisburg on a fumble by Sullivan as Holly recovers it in the end zone.
Waiting for the official call. It's a hold against Cedar Rapids. And it's a touchdown. So there's, let's just say it, there's the second turnover and points from it. And all of a sudden, the momentum is 100% in Harrisburg's favor. That shotgun snap goes wide. You can see the hold. And then the ball was actually knocked out by Devin Thomas. Devin Thomas, one of the captains from Southern Miss. He's a son of former NFL player Adalius Thomas. He swatted the ball away, and then it was picked up in the end zone by Josh Holly for 6.
And what a way for Holly to be rewarded. We've seen him make a number of key plays defensively in the first half. Falls on it for the touchdown. Harrisburg ahead 28-20. Extra point up and through as the Stampede take a 9-point lead to the locker room in their season opener and will receive the kickoff in the second half. We'll take a break. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Harrisburg Stampede Football on SFBN.
Springtime is the right time to go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get big time selection. Choose from rows and rows of new 2024 Pilots, Accords, Passports, and more. Get big time savings. Drive a new Civic, just $299 a month. Choose from a great selection of Honda CRVs from just $379 a month. It's springtime, so go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get started at FaulknerHonda.com, to be sure.
Simplify your life. Belco's checking accounts are easy to use, and most accounts have no minimum balance requirements or monthly service charges. No matter what bells are ringing, you can rely on checking with Belco. Because we believe in every person, every dream, every time. Join today at belco.org or any local branch. Belco Community Credit Union. Believe in better banking.
Halftime here in Harrisburg as Stampede legend Will Hines having his jersey retired by the organization he became a legend playing for. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, I'm sure Will and all the alumni of this organization are pleased with what they saw from the Stampede in the first half. It wasn't promising early on. Starting quarterback Caleb Walton went down with an injury during introductions, and the Stampede had to turn to Isaac Hurd. Cedar Rapids received the ball first and scored quickly and efficiently. Harrisburg played trailing most of the half, but they forced the River Kings to turn the ball over twice towards the tail end of the second quarter and jumped out to a 9-point lead. The biggest play of the half, that fumble at the buzzer, Joshua Holly falling on it for a touchdown. And in a game where Harrisburg was outplayed for the bulk of the first half, they've got a 9-point lead in the locker room and the ball to start the third.
And not only do they have a 9-point lead, they're on a 16-0 run, if you will. It was 20-13 Cedar Rapids at one point. Then all of a sudden you have the safety, and then you get more points after that, and the points just kept coming for the Harrisburg Stampede. You had the touchdown catch from Aaron Brown, and then the touchdown right at the buzzer for Josh Holly. I talked about how Cedar Rapids, hey, you got one chance to go deep. That not only couldn't they go deep, they couldn't get out of their own way. And Holly falls on the loose ball after Devin Thomas swats it away, and all of the momentum in the world is on Harrisburg's side. I mean, you mentioned the Caleb Walton injury. Certainly thinking of him and hoping that it ultimately isn't as bad as it looked pregame, but it looked pretty bad. He was helped off the field favoring that left leg, and, you know, 30 years old, give or take a year, and you're playing professional football here with the Harrisburg Stampede. You could never imagine that something like that would happen during pregame.
Let's take a look at stats. All these unofficial, we're doing our best to keep track here in our booth. For the River Kings, Kaylor Sullivan, an unofficial 5-for-8 through the air with 57 yards and 3 touchdown passes. Those 3 touchdowns came on the first 3 offensive possessions for the River Kings. Verlin Reed with a score. Donovan Johnson had 2 touchdown catches. But after the first 3 possessions, turnover by the River Kings.
We've said it once, we've said it twice, and I'll say it again. When we talked to Coach Bernie Nowotarski, he said, I want 2 turnovers and 2 defensive stops. Not only did he get that, but he got points off of both of those turnovers slash defensive stops, and I'm not sure, as a coach, he could want more.
On the flip side for Harrisburg, their quarterback, Isaac Hurd, 5-for-8 with 61 yards through the air. 2 passing touchdowns, 1 to Todd Simmons, 1 to Aaron Brown. And Hurd also ran one in for a touchdown as well. Holly with the touchdown on a fumble recovery. And how about the play by Isaac Hurd at the quarterback position? Wasn't the intended starter for this season opener. And coming off the bench with the game plan designed for somebody else, has his team ahead by 9 at the half.
Isaac Hurd has done an amazing job today for the Harrisburg Stampede. He's from Southern Oregon University, an NAIA school, ultimately from Hawaii. And with the weather we've seen in central Pennsylvania this week, there had to be at least one point where he's thinking, wait, I could be in Hawaii or I could be in a torrential downpour for 4 consecutive days. Well, he has made the best of this wet week in central PA by scoring in just about every way possible early on in a situation that I'm sure he never thought he'd be in. But any quarterback will tell you, you always have to be ready to play.
Harrisburg ahead of Cedar Rapids by 9 here at the half. We'll take a quick break and return with a brief conversation with Stampede head coach Bernie Nowotarski. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Harrisburg Stampede football on SFBN.
You up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom. Tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Springtime is the right time to go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get big time selection. Choose from rows and rows of new 2024 Pilots, Accords, Passports, and more. Get big time savings. Drive a new Civic, just $299 a month. Choose from a great selection of Honda CRVs from just $379 a month. It's springtime, so go big time at Faulkner Honda in Harrisburg. Get started at FaulknerHonda.com to be sure.
Simplify your life. Belco's checking accounts are easy to use, and most accounts have no minimum balance requirements or monthly service charges. No matter what bells are ringing, you can rely on checking with Belco. Because we believe in every person, every dream, every time. Join today at belco.org or any local branch. Belco Community Credit Union. Believe in better banking.
Complex for tonight's Harrisburg Stampede indoor football game. The Stampede leading the Cedar Rapids River Kings 29-20. Mike Garland, Chris Markowitz on the call, and we're going to send it down to the field for Chris right now with head coach Bernie Nowotarski. Chris?
Halftime here in Harrisburg. Coach, your team ahead by nine. Caleb got hurt in introductions, so Isaac comes in. Strong start for him, not expecting to get the start tonight. What have you liked from him, Isaac Hurd, as your backup coming in and playing well in the first half at the quarterback spot?
Well, I mean, we certainly didn't expect him to come right in. I mean, we knew through the course of the season he would play, but, I mean, it's a shame for Caleb going down, but it's kind of the old next man up, and that's what he was here for, and he was fighting for a starting job to begin with. So, and this gives him a chance to get in there and do what he's here for.
Now, defensively, you told us two stops and two turnovers usually gets it done. They came out strong offensively, scored on their first three possessions, but then you forced two key turnovers after that, especially that touchdown by Holly on the fumble recovery at the buzzer. What flipped for you guys defensively at the end of the half?
Well, I think we're finally settling in to playing defense. Again, I was concerned in the beginning of the game with adrenaline and, you know, making mistakes. Now it seems like we're settling in, and I think we're wearing down their offensive line. Our speed is starting to show.
Coach, thanks for the time. Good luck in the second half. Mike, back up to you.
Thanks a lot, Chris. And as both teams come back to the carpet here at the Pennsylvania State Farm Show Complex, they get ready to kick off what should be an exciting second half of indoor football action. The Harrisburg Stampede at one point trailed 20-13 in the second quarter, then a safety, then a touchdown, then another touchdown, and all of a sudden they went from down 7 to up 9. So a 16-0 run for the Stampede to wrap up the second half. And these two teams, as they get warmed up, we saw a rousing drumline and step show at halftime. The only thing that was missing from it was more cowbell, but the audience, the arena, they were on their feet and they were having a good time. And the Harrisburg Stampede organization has done a great job engaging the community and getting them out here to experience this game. And if the home team can go home with a win, that's even more excitement for these fans and just another reason to get them to come back for week two, which, oh, by the way, is next Saturday right here at the Farm Show Complex, as Harrisburg will be taking on the Maryland Eagles with a start time of 7 p.m. All right, Chris, you heard it from Coach Nowotarski himself. They're starting to wear down Cedar Rapids. And I think the only thing that would make what we've seen better is if Harrisburg can fix that quarterback center exchange problem that we've seen all throughout the first half.
Well, and I think the most interesting thing Coach said to me during that conversation was the concept of being overhyped coming into this game. And I was with the team following them out of the locker room at around 6 o'clock when they came out prior to intros. You could tell players were hyped up, they were excited for this, but maybe those pregame jitters played a little bit of factor in those exchanges. They got cleaner offensively as the game went around in the tail end of that second quarter. And the defense switching things up and getting the two turnovers, that's been the biggest difference so far.
Well, it's gotta be exciting for all of these guys to be out here, whether you're for Cedar Rapids or you're for Harrisburg. I mentioned to you off-air pregame, everybody at this age, you want that one more go around. You want that one more try. And some of these guys, maybe they're playing to get picked up by a UFL team or get seen by a Canadian team. There are other indoor leagues as well. Everybody of a certain age wants that one more go around, that one more ride on the carousel. And for some of them, it starts tonight, and for others, it will continue for years to come.
Well, and I think hearts have to go out for Caleb Walton, though. Obviously a tough night for him. Amped up to be able to have this opportunity tonight and then doesn't even get to take a snap. And you could hear how heartbroken Coach was, you know, having his intended starting quarterback unable to make the start tonight. He's happy with what Isaac Hurd has done, but Caleb Walton out for tonight, and no reports as to what the official injury is yet, but it seems like word in the locker room is he could be missing some serious time.
You know, the way he was helped off the field was favoring that left leg, so whether it was an ankle or a knee, we just don't know. We're not doctors here, although I've paid to see a few over the course of my life. But, yeah, it's an unfortunate thing, and as Ted Lasso would say, unlucky. And now these two teams will get ready to start the second half, and they're doing so in the same somewhat confused manner that they did in the first half, where everybody goes to one end of the field, and then they go the other way.
Well, it's good to know that I'm not the only one slightly confused about what's going on here as well. Familiarizing myself with the rules of arena football, but it's been fun. I love the pace of what we're seeing so far, Mike, and the fans really enjoying themselves here tonight in Harrisburg.
Fake it till you make it, Chris. Fake it till you make it, buddy.
Meanwhile, it's Cedar Rapids to kick off left to right on your screen, dressed in their road gray jerseys with black pants. Harrisburg will receive in their home blue going right to left. Marcus Taylor back deep to return. Line drive kick. Taylor backpedals into the end zone. Room to run up the middle. Wrapped up at the 13 and brought down there. Nice tackle made by Deshaun Schumann, the 5'9 defensive back from Concordia St. Paul University.
So the Stampede with their first possession of the second half. First down and 10 from about the 13-yard line. So this is around the average field position that we were seeing for the Stampede in the first quarter. But the difference between the first and second quarters, night and day. Of course, the Stampede able to capitalize on a couple of penalties and turnovers for points in the second quarter. But in the first quarter, it was a long field.
And this is where ball control becomes such a big factor for Harrisburg. Ahead by two scores right now, what you want to focus on is keeping possession of the football. First and 10, Hurd with time. Deep ball. Over the middle and a touchdown on the opening play of the third quarter. Todd Simmons, for the second time tonight, scores for Harrisburg.
Todd Simmons has gone deep twice tonight for the Harrisburg Stampede. Now a flag at the 4-yard line, likely excessive celebration, maybe some pushing and shoving. Some of the Stampede coaches are out saying they want to decline, but it might not be your penalty to decline. We will see.
It's a 32-yard strike through the air. One more look.
And that shotgun snap was online. And that pass, beautiful, as Hurd dropped it right into the awaiting arms of Todd Simmons, who caught it in stride and into the end zone.
And no penalty. And check that 37-yard strike through the air. Hurd with his second touchdown pass over 30 yards tonight. His third touchdown pass of the evening. Largest lead for either team as Panaccio adds on to it. And the Stampede with a 16-point advantage early on in the third quarter. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, concerns set in right before kickoff as Caleb Walton, the starting quarterback for Harrisburg, went down with an injury. But Isaac Hurd hasn't missed a beat tonight.
It is next man up, exactly as Coach said. And you can see Hurd one more time as you take a look at this. Drops it on a dime to Todd Simmons. You think back to, you know, situations where the starting quarterback gets hurt. One time there was this guy named Drew Bledsoe, and he got jacked. And then all of a sudden this unknown backup came in off the bench. What was this, Tom something or other? And they worked out pretty well for him.
That sounds like a familiar story.
Yeah, exactly. And it's happened. Carson Wentz gets hurt for the Eagles, and Nick Foles takes them to a Super Bowl championship. And they're building statues outside of Lincoln Financial Field for Nick Foles. And Carson Wentz now on his third or fourth go-around as a backup, this time signing with Kansas City.
See, as a Giant fan growing up, I'm more of a Jeff Hostetler kind of guy.
Jeff Hostetler.
Special teams, longtime veteran, turns to Super Bowl champ.
He is a Central Pennsylvania guy, is Jeff Hostetler.
Mustache Jeff.
Super Bowl 25.
One of the greatest game plans in football history.
No bias there, right?
Absolutely not.
None.
Back deep to return for Cedar Rapids is Bright. He fields it in his own end zone and has room to run across the far sidelines. Spills out across the 22, down at the 23. So the River Kings continue to get quality returns from Bright.
Coach Panuccio with the tackle, and this time I'm using the term properly. Joe Panuccio, the kicker. Family from the Palmyra area. We understand they run a pizza shop in the area. He went to college at Ryder, and now a varsity soccer coach in Central Pennsylvania. In fact, he led his Mechanicsburg Wildcat squad to the state tournament this past fall, and he's made a couple of extra points, and gets credit for that tackle, too.
Yeah, great story. Local kid, comes from a family with a local business, really in the heart of the community here and a part of something special for the Stampede this season. First down and 10 for the River Kings, meanwhile, on their own 23. New quarterback in, it's Verlin Reed, maybe out of a Wildcat. This handoff goes nowhere. It was bright on the carry, but met very quickly by Devin Thomas and Anelio Pena.
Well, Verlin Reed staying in the game to play quarterback, so it's an interesting change at the quarterback position by head coach Darren Clark, because I would argue that Kaylor Sullivan played fine. He was a serviceable quarterback. The issue wasn't with the Cedar Rapids offense, at least from a quarterback standpoint. It was from penalties.
Well, you have to wonder, how much of a factor are those back-to-back safety touchdown fumbles in terms of that decision? I don't know how much you could blame Sullivan for that. They weren't great snaps, as this is nearly intercepted. Daria in the area can't make the catch, and Reed fortunate that that throw hit the turf.
And Reed was a quarterback. He played at Ohio State University, then transferred to D2 Findlay. He was the IFL Rookie of the Year. He's scored a touchdown today already. Now, as a quarterback, has a chance to contribute to this offense in a different way.
And this is a big moment for both teams. Harrisburg with a chance to get the ball back, potentially. Already ahead by 16. The River Kings really need points on this drive. Third and 11. Men in motion. Aaron snap. Reed comes down with it. Sprints away. Throws to the end zone. Off target. Intended in the corner for Robert Major. And that brings up fourth and 11. Good pressure on the play by Harrisburg.
And again, you don't kick punt, or you don't punt in this league. You could go for a long field goal right now, but the Cedar Rapids offense is going to stay on the field. There was another fumbled shotgun snap, and Reed ends up scrambling, running for his life. And that pass was a good 10 yards out of bounds. Really no receivers in the area for that one.
Devin Thomas in on the play with the initial pressure. He's made some huge plays. Helped to generate that fumble for a touchdown at the buzzer going into the half. Fourth and 11 here for the River Kings, who do not want to give the Stampede the ball back in their own territory. Reed over the middle, intercepted, picked off at the 10, and running it back for Harrisburg, number 30, Jeremy Lewis. One of those situations where maybe it would have been better had he just dropped the ball field position wise, but they're not going to complain as they force their third turnover of the day.
And I believe that's the third consecutive turnover on as many possessions, as Davis turns it over and the receiver had fallen down. So that really took the one intended target out of the equation, leaving Jeremy Lewis playing center field to corral that one. And he brought the ball across midfield to about the 23-yard line.
And talk about polarities. The River Kings came out and scored touchdowns on each of their first three drives. The last three drives for them have all ended with turnovers.
Well, this is a River Kings team that lost 87-14 to the Missouri Falcons during week one of their season. Rebounded last week to win 35-26 against the Colorado Spartans. But right now we're seeing more of a team that played against Missouri.
Very high snap. Hurd has to go back to keep it out of the end zone, and does. Keeps the play alive, throws to the close sideline, caught by Brown. It's a loss of five, but penalty flags flew immediately. So we'll have a long conversation about this one. A lot of sloppy things happened there.
That was a big pile of ugly, Chris. And the officials coming together to have a conversation. Maybe a little bit of a chuckle about that shotgun snap as well.
Both teams thought there was a penalty. And they get an offside call against Dwayne Stewart.
The only thing missing on that play was the Benny Hill theme song. But a nice job by Isaac Hurd chasing that one down, picking it back up, and then for Aaron Brown to get in the area. Well, ultimately, it's all for naught because that penalty is way better than whatever just happened on that play. So instead of it being second down and about 14, it's first down and five.
Penalties killing the River Kings right now. We saw them pick up five flags in the last 4 minutes of the first half as they continue to see yellow laundry all over the turf. Stretch pass here to Simmons, who gets plowed into the boards. Strong hit there by Austin Wood.
I wouldn't be surprised if that gets scored a running play, but either way, Simmons advances it about 4 yards. He's just short of the line to gain, and those folks sitting in the front row, they certainly got more than they bargained for with those box seats here at the State Farm Show Complex. A nice job pitching it left, then the big hit against the dasher boards, and that young lady, she wasn't as attentive as she probably should be when you're sitting in the front row.
Yeah, definitely not the place to be scrolling on your phone. Fortunately, she was not.
But the guy behind her is.
Meanwhile, Hurd on second down completes a pass to the right sideline. It's Gorman, who's been a key target for short pickups tonight.
It's going to move the chains. A short pickup it is, but first down and 10 now for Harrisburg on another drive that could culminate in points.
Hurd 3 for 3 in the second half for 47 total yards. 8 for 11 overall. He's been accurate tonight.
He has been accurate when he hasn't been running for his life.
But he has the speed and quickness to be able to make plays in the backfield, and that is such a key in this league.
He's elusive and can avoid danger.
7:30 and counting here in the third quarter. Hurd with time. Not a lot of pressure as he underthrows Howard. That had 6 points written all over it. What a nice play defensively by Austin Wood to break up the pass. Had it been perhaps a foot higher, that's a touchdown.
Yeah, Howard was definitely in the area. Aaron Brown was definitely in the area and looking to make that catch. But from a defensive standpoint, even though the DB fell down, he fell down right into a perfect spot to knock the ball away.
So second and 10 now, first incomplete pass of the half by Isaac Hurd. This Stampede offense in a great rhythm right now. Hurd taking his time, signals two men in motion. Looking left, he'll run right. Wrapped up for a short gain. Barely got anything there. Stewart on the tackle, but a flag comes in late.
There was a really big guy chasing Isaac Hurd there, and I'm not sure which would have hurt worse, being hit by the big guy or the wall.
And it's a face mask penalty on Stewart. One more look here. Penalties continue to kill the River Kings.
And the face mask was on the tackle. He not only grabbed, he held and pulled him down by the mask. That's Dwayne Stewart. We mentioned it before, 6'4", 310. You're not hiding out there when you're that big.
First and goal for Harrisburg from the Cedar Rapids 5. The Stampede knocking on the door, looking to make this a 3-score contest. Hurd with time. Brown, short gain. Got about 2 yards there, a big target. And in this area of the field, so difficult to complete passes, Mike, just because there's hardly any real estate to work with.
No, the end zones look to be 5 to 7 yards deep, and they curve in the corners, so you don't have the true corners of an end zone. And, yeah, you just run out of real estate the closer you get to the goal line itself.
5:30 and counting here in the third quarter. Harrisburg moving methodically on this drive. Handoff. And look at the powerful Giovanni Franklin fighting for every inch, brought down just shy of the end zone.
We didn't get the heights and weights of the Harrisburg Stampede players, but we know Giovanni Franklin is from Alaska. He played rugby, and we saw a bit of a scrum there as he took that handoff and surged forward. You know, they're having WrestleMania tonight at Lincoln Financial Field, and the Eagles made the Philly special, the tush push something special, and we saw a bit of a push there before the whistles from the official signified the stop of the play.
And with it being third and goal from the one, do we see a variation of that here? Doesn't look like it with Hurd in the shotgun. Everyone offensively on the left side of the line. Hurd runs that way, and it is brought down shy of the end zone, may have lost the half yard there.
He is short. They tried that quarterback draw that I called for at the end of the first half, and this time a little bit short, so it's going to bring up fourth down, and Aaron Brown comes back out onto the field, so certainly points to be had here for the Harrisburg Stampede. I believe Cedar Rapids has only stopped this Harrisburg offense once all night long.
Harrisburg leaving the offense out there, trying to put the, not the nail in the coffin, a lot of time here, but a third touchdown will make this difficult for the River Kings to climb back into it. Cedar Rapids desperate for a stop here.
It might not be the final nail, but it's one of the first.
Heard. Aaron throw, had a man open. A flag flies. Simmons the intended man, but hold everything.
Some pushing and shoving in the end zone as well with Aaron Brown and one of the secondary men for Cedar Rapids.
So they get Aaron Brown with a holding call. Penalty declined. And one more look here.
Not a great throw that time around, and then the hold penalty. So even if it would have been completed, it would have been a redo for the Stampede. Instead of, it's a turnover on downs. But this Harrisburg defense, which has been clicking, now has a chance to maybe pick up a second safety, maybe some more points off of turnover here, because the quarterback center exchange for Cedar Rapids hasn't been all that great either over the last couple of series.
Well, that was a huge stop for the River Kings, but to your point, this area right here has been their Achilles heel tonight. An errant snap led to a safety midway through the second quarter for Cedar Rapids, and on the final play of the half, an errant snap led to a defensive touchdown. Verlin Reed returns at the quarterback spot. Clock rolling with 3:32 remaining, and another bad snap, this one out of the back of the end zone. And another nightmare for the River Kings. It's a safety, more points on a turnover for Harrisburg.
If they'd have been just a little bit over to the left, the ball would have gone over the crossbar. Just another challenging quarterback center exchange. This one didn't stand a chance. This is the third game of the season. I can't imagine this is the first time that man has snapped the ball. I just don't get it.
Fourth turnover tonight for the River Kings. Third on a bad snap.
And I get that these are limited rosters, but I know that, I feel like an old man saying this, back in my day, if I had snapped the ball over the quarterback's head that many times, I wouldn't have had another opportunity to do it. I would have gone to the bench, and it wouldn't have been by choice.
Well, Harrisburg not complaining about the turnover as the Stampede will have possession of the football with 3:06 remaining in the third quarter. Ahead by 18 points, Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, after a slow start defensively, the Stampede getting all the breaks right now.
Harrisburg has outscored Cedar Rapids 25-0 over the last quarter and a half. It was 20-13 at one point for Cedar Rapids.
The home crowd enjoying what they're seeing. This has been a dream start for Coach Noah Tarski, his staff, and his team. Taylor on the return, fields it against the boards. Taylor across the five, brought down and around the seven, there's a flag down.
Probably a few too many flags to the liking of both coaches tonight. The first quarter felt like it was a fairly clean game, and it's sort of devolved after that. Anilio Pena called for the foul, and now Harrisburg will start from inside their own five.
And now the pressure on the Stampede. We have seen Harrisburg struggle a little bit with offensive snaps as well tonight. The River Kings with an opportunity defensively here to make a big play, trying to climb back into this one, down 18 with 2:45 to go in the third.
And a reminder, Stampede fans, The Harrisburg Stampede home next Saturday here at the Farm Show Complex against the Maryland Eagles. SFBN will have the coverage as well, but nothing can replicate the in-person experience. So get on out and check it out.
On first down, Hurd with a short pass to Taylor. Screenplay, and it goes for a solid gain. Taylor wrapped up by Smith near the first down marker. Looks like he's going to be given the 10-yard pickup, and that's a great play call for Harrisburg. Backed up in their own end zone, and they go to the bubble screen.
A nice pitch and catch. You get the man in motion, and you get the screen coming out of the backfield as Marcus Taylor stayed, caught the pass, couple of spins, and first down and 10.
Hurd now 5 for 6 through the air in the second half. He's been so efficient through the air. First and 10 from the Harrisburg 14. Hurd steps up, tries to run, and picks up 2.5 yards on the carry.
Well, there was a path for the briefest of moments, but that Red Sea that had parted closed rather quickly.
But the Stampede in no hurry right now, and for them, Mike, they just want to hold on to the football and let precious time tick off the clock ahead by 18.
Yeah, to quote the Steve Miller Band, time keeps on ticking into the future, man. Why rush it? You're up 38-20. There's absolutely no reason to force things, to have a turnover. We saw it happen to Cedar Rapids at the end of the first half. They were trying to get a playoff and instead gave up 6 points.
Hurd motions two from the backfield. High snap, hauls it in, throws over the middle, and it's in and out of the hands of Aaron Brown. That was a first down and potentially a lot more, but he was unable to squeeze it.
Yeah, just a little bit high, and he couldn't haul it in. And there are times I look at Aaron Brown, and he strikes me as the kind of guy that maybe was a lineman at one point. And you can see that Hurd's pass was just a little bit high, and you put that one on the numbers, it's a first down and then some. You put it a little bit high, and a guy that doesn't usually catch a pass or maybe didn't catch passes when he was in college, it's a whole different thing.
Running clock here. Let's see if Harrisburg tries one more play before the quarter break. They do. High snap. Hurd hauls it in. He'll roll right, tuck the football, and be brought down for a sack, a loss of 1 on the tackle by Jonathan Jones. And that takes us to the fourth quarter with Harrisburg ahead of Cedar Rapids by 18. Take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Harrisburg Stampede Football on SFBN. Quarter here in Harrisburg, the Stampede facing a 4th and 8 deep in their own territory, but leading by 18 points. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. Mike, Harrisburg trailed early. They were down most of the first half, but on a 25-0 scoring run right now. And the big story for Cedar Rapids, 4 turnovers.
Cedar Rapids has not done themselves any favors with the turnovers and the penalties, and all of a sudden they're a shell-shocked franchise here in this second half, and it's going to be fourth down and long for the Stampede. And if Cedar Rapids has any chance to claw back into this one, they're going to need a defensive stop right now.
Well, it's fourth and, check that, 11 for Harrisburg out of the huddle here on their own 13. So if the River Kings can get a stop, they'll be in great position to put points on the board. Motion up front. This might be an offside penalty. Potential free play as Hurd had an open man. Simmons was the intended target. But this looks like it will be another play for Harrisburg on the penalty.
We talked about turnovers. We talked about penalties. And here you go. Instead of it being a turnover on downs, Cedar Rapids jumps off sides, moves the chains, and it goes from 4th and 11 to 4th and 6. So still 4th and long for the Stampede, but much more manageable. And beyond that, another opportunity.
Turnovers and penalties have been holding this Cedar Rapids team back all evening long. And now the Stampede, due to the running clock, can allow more time to tick off here and get a second crack at picking up a first down.
Speaking of ticked off, I don't think Cedar Rapids is very happy about their performance in the second half.
Fourth and six. Hurd, far sideline. And it is caught. Late whistle there. It was close, but the officials say Taylor able to hold on to the football going to the turf.
He needed six. He got about eight, and you can see right here he ran to the chains. He turned around, and he waited, and that ball came right to him. He corralled it. The chains will move, and that first down is made possible by that previous offsides penalty by Cedar Rapids. Without that five-yard offside, you don't get a six-yard first down.
And Isaac Hurd now 6 for 7 in the second half through the air, having thrown for 67 yards. It's like he's shooting fish in a barrel right now. He cannot miss, consistently hitting guys open in the flat and over the middle.
Now, whether it's catching fish or shooting fish, Isaac Hurd's getting the job done from an angling standpoint.
From midfield now. End zone, open man, touchdown, Todd Simmons for the third time tonight.
Todd Simmons to Isaac Hurd to Todd Simmons. I think that's something that Stampede fans can learn to enjoy here this season.
Three touchdowns for the Wagner man, Todd Simmons, and all three have been on deep balls from Hurd.
I believe Wagner, they are the Seahawks, and he has certainly been flying tonight.
Panaccio on to try the extra point. The Stampede ahead by 24 with a chance to make it 25.
It's still crazy to think this was once a 20-13 game, Chris.
And the kick no good. 24-point advantage for Harrisburg with the clock paused at 12:36 remaining in the fourth. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, Harrisburg has been impressive tonight. I think what's been most impressive about it is they got off to a slow start, but they made the adjustments. Coach Noah Tarski and his staff cleaned things up on the offensive and defensive side of the football, and they're on a 31-0 run since midway through the second quarter.
That is an epic run by any stretch, whether it's basketball or football, and to have it here tonight in the home opener for the Harrisburg Stampede. The crowd is hype, and they're having a good time. They really have seen a show. It is the greatest show on turf, if I may steal a phrase from the St. Louis Rams and the Kurt Warner days. And I don't just mean the Stampede is the greatest show on turf. Arena football is fun. I think the NFL could learn a thing or two about having receivers in motion. The Canadian League does it. The Arena League does it. It just adds an extra dynamic. And in the NFL, when passing is such a big deal, why not put those men in motion?
Well, the fans loving it here at Harrisburg. Justin Cobble, their owner, loving what he's seeing as well. And he's put together quite the team and environment for the Stampede as they've gotten off to a strong start as we're early on in the fourth quarter of their season opener. Still some time left for the River Kings, though. And Mike, What do they have to do to have a chance? Time running out. It's not over yet. They've basically got to play it perfect from here on out, though.
I don't think you can dink and dunk at this point. You've got to go at it. The Stampede, in a sense, actually get penalized by that over-the-end board touchback by Panuccio because it becomes first and 10 from the 20. So you only have 30 yards to pay dirt. You can do it on one play, so go get it.
Verlin Reed, once again, will call the plays at the quarterback spot. Interesting that we still do not see Sullivan, who had some decent success moving the football offensively in the first half. Reed over the middle, and it's hauled in. Nice catch by Terrell Carey, who brings it in for a 13-yard gain.
How about the quick movement by the umpire, Aaron Jamin, there at the second level? A couple of whistles now. And they do rule it a catch. I think Jamin may have been a little shell-shocked there. He got down quick. Beats the alternative of getting hit in the face.
Well, in precious time, though, still ticking off the clock here for Cedar Rapids. So surprised to see them moving so slowly, going into the huddle and taking a lot of time to get to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, I would imagine there's a play clock at this level. Though I'd be shocked if any team ever got a delay of game in the Arena League or in indoor football.
Reed with time. Open man, end zone, incomplete. Just a bit too high for Donovan Johnson, who went for it with his right hand. Perhaps if he goes up with two, he had a play on it. It was a bit behind him, though.
It was a little bit behind him, and maybe if he turns the other way, he hauls it in as well. You know, the old adage is if you're a receiver and it hits you in the hands, you should catch it. But that one was just a little offline, and he maybe turned the wrong way as well.
Yeah, on second glance there, Reed, if he puts that ball to the left shoulder, it would have given Johnson a far better chance to haul it in. Second and 10 now from the Harrisburg 18. Clock still moving here. Cedar Rapids in no hurry. Reed scrambles right, avoids a sack, fires end zone. It's a prayer unanswered. Man down in the corner for Cedar Rapids. The intended receiver was Robert Major.
And you know, these wide receivers can go in motion, and I have to wonder what constitutes offsides, because I've seen a few times these guys going in motion and they seem to be a foot or two past the line of scrimmage before the ball is snapped. So maybe it's they were in the vicinity of the line of scrimmage when the ball was snapped, so just go for it.
9:44 and counting here in the fourth. The River Kings running out of time, trailing by 24 points. And they haven't scored since midway through the second. High snap, Reed comes down with it, looks to run. Good pickup here as he breaks the tackle and has the first down yardage on a 10-yard scamper.
That became playground football right there, Chris. Another high snap, and he corralled it and did a little something on his own. And something that Cedar Rapids has struggled with throughout is that quarterback-center exchange. It's been a repetitive theme for both teams, really, although Harrisburg seems to have corralled their problems in the second half. And he advanced it forward to pick up that first down. And if you're head coach Ron Clark, do you really care? The chains move. Doesn't matter how you got there at this point.
But 5 minutes have come off the clock on this Cedar Rapids drive. And that is what Harrisburg wants, just time to tick. Reed on a pitch right. Good angle. Johnson brought down shy of the goal line and some extracurriculars here. No penalty flags, but you could see a little chippiness out there on the turf.
A little chippy, and I almost have to wonder if someone wasn't trying to bait someone as well, because you got that initial push and that initial shove. Then the hands went up and said, oh, look what he's doing. Look what he's doing. You see it one more time. A running play, which we haven't seen too many of, at least called running plays in this game, and it picks up a few yards. Then that pushing and shoving, which amounted to nothing there other than two men posturing.
Second and goal for the River Kings from the Harrisburg 3. Reed has been effective on this drive. High snap. gets it down and keeps it, but he's brought down for a loss. Devin Thomas in on the tackle.
Devin Thomas had a sack earlier, which caused a touchdown, or resulted in a touchdown, if you will. He knocked the ball out of the hands of the first half quarterback, Kaylor Sullivan, and this time around gets his second sack of the game. And I'll tell you what, Chris, Cedar Rapids looking for their first points since early in the second quarter.
7:24 remaining in the game, and they really need points right now, do the River Kings. Running out of time here in our final quarter of regulation. Under center, first time we see that from either team. Reed off the back heel, incomplete. And I think this is an obvious fourth down and goal, go for a touchdown situation.
I talked about it earlier with those shotgun snaps with regards to Harrisburg. I said, at what point do you go under center? And maybe that's what happened right there. Like, hey guys, we really need some yards here. Let's not screw this up. Do something for sure and go to the old quarterback center exchange from a standard under center.
Now this may be the final nail in the coffin if Cedar Rapids is unable to score. So the River Kings call timeout with 6:36 remaining here in the fourth. We'll keep it here. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, Harrisburg ahead by 24.
They're going to kick a field goal.
Ah, interesting here.
What's the spread on this one?
That I do not know.
I mean, you're down by 24. You haven't scored since the second quarter, and you call a timeout to bring the field goal unit on. Either that or the kicker is going to be part of this on-field promotion that's about to happen.
Well, with 6:36 remaining, a field goal through the uprights does make it a three-possession game. But you would think this is touchdown and two-point try territory, given that a 24-point lead far easier to overcome if you get three touchdowns and convert on some extra points.
Now, drop kicks are a thing in this league. Those are worth 4 points, so, you know, who knows? Maybe there'll be a drop kick coming here. 3 points for a field goal, 4 points for a drop kick. You know, we haven't seen a drop kick since Doug Flutie.
We'll take a quick break. Fourth quarter action going on live here in Harrisburg. .36 remaining in the fourth quarter here in Harrisburg. The Stampede ahead by 24 in their season opener and their return to arena football for the first time since 2014. The River Kings lining up for a field goal here. This one from about 18 yards out, yeah.
I don't know how long the end zones are.
Confusion on the snap, no flags, kick up and good. So it will count for 3 points.
There might be a flag.
Late conversation here.
Because the right guard didn't do much of anything but stand up and point. So was there encroachment or contact made? We just saw our first indoor football field goal. Field goal is good. And now it is, they're going to keep the points on the board. So the scoring drought has been broken by the River Kings with that three-point try.
First time they're able to put points on the board since midway through the second quarter. Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, with 6:36 remaining in this contest, not over. It's a difficult comeback, but look, people have made this comeback before. Peyton Manning and the Colts 20 years ago, trailing by 21 against Tampa Bay late with 4 minutes to go.
Oh, totally the same thing.
If you're Cedar Rapids here, what breaks do you have to have go your way in order to climb back into this one?
You have to hope for another errant shotgun snap. I assume onsides kicks are a thing in this league, so maybe you try one of those. But you've got to play perfect defense. You've got to go first four and out, get the ball back as fast as you can and utilize your two remaining timeouts. Although if you're Harrisburg, I would encourage them to do exactly what I watched my daughter's soccer team do today, which is stand around and do a whole lot of nothing and watch the clock just run. Here would we be by choice. There, I think it was confusion.
Well, here it's perfectly appropriate to your point to see Stampede players picking dandelions if they get the ball back right now.
As long as the Stampede players don't go take the ball from the other Stampede players.
It will be an onside try here from the River Kings. Taylor, the lone deep man, they send it to him, not ready for it. He picks it up in his own end zone. This might be very poor field position for Harrisburg and very well played by Cedar Rapids, catching the Stampede off guard there as they'll have it on their own 2-yard line.
Well, that's one way to do it. You get the squib kick, nobody back to block, and then you're running like a man that has people chasing him, which they were, and you get tackled at the 2 or the 1.5. We saw with Cedar Rapids and Aaron Snap over the dasher boards, 2 points for the defense. I mean, they just got 3 on the field goal. You get 2 more and you get the ball back. I've never been part of a game with 3 safeties, but I guess there's a first time for everything.
And now some confusion here before this.
From us or them?
I think all around.
Okay.
They do whistle the clock to start. So
I like that.
6:24 and counting here in regulation. Hurd backed up in his own end zone.
Yeah, 1 wide receiver and 4 guys from the chain crew over there in the far side corner.
Not a lot of real estate. Whistle here. And is this against Harrisburg? It is, so.
Well, that half the distance thing is going to be real rough here.
Well, the limited room they already had getting smaller, but yeah, to your point. I mean, I don't know, would you be a proponent of a safety in that scenario?
Not on purpose, no. No, I mean, you only lost 1 yard on the penalty, so it's not ideal, but 1st and 11, 1st and 10, that doesn't make much difference here.
I was suggesting a rule change, like a false start with your quarterback lined up in the gun in the end zone.
Yeah, no. Now, no, I'm good with what happened here. I like the safety if there's holding in the end zone.
So after the penalty, it's 1st and 12 for Harrisburg on their own 1. Cedar Rapids desperate for a safety here. Hurd with time. Launches a deep ball. Close sideline. Incomplete. Gorman the intended man, but he was blanketed the whole way by Smith.
That's the 2nd target for that lady in the hoodie tonight. She hasn't caught one yet.
But she keeps getting open, and eventually you'd have to think that leads to yards.
I mean, she's currently covered. There's a guy in a hat down there who's made his move. I mean, nowhere to drop for Hurd that time around, so you're throwing flat-footed. She needs to catch one tonight, Chris.
Well, the benefit in this league, though, for Harrisburg, even with an incomplete pass, the clock continues to run. 2nd down and 12 with under 5 minutes remaining.
It benefits a lot of people, Chris. But still nowhere to go for Hurd in the end zone.
Her scrambles right, hit hard into the boards. Strong shove by Austin Wood.
That lady did not drop her beer. She went down hard on the sideline, kept the beer held high. Now a little slow to get up, but to the football action, jokes aside, that was a big hit into the boards. And we talked about Hurd. He had nowhere to go in the end zone. Finally got across the goal line, maybe some helmet to helmet. And look at that right there. White jacket goes down, holds it high. That thing probably cost like $10. You got to save that.
And that's our play of the game. Didn't even happen inside the arena.
I've been trying to get this lady a catch all game. That lady just holds onto her beverage.
Under 4 minutes remaining now. Hurd with time. Far sideline complete for Taylor. Short of the yard to gain.
And you would have to wonder at what point does Cedar Rapids concede the inevitable here. They do still have 2 timeouts in their pocket. It was not the time. I wasn't encouraging them there. They must be watching on YouTube.
Well, they do follow your advice and burn the timeout with 3:41 remaining.
Sorry.
Chris Markowitz alongside Mike Garland. And Mike, 4th and 5, if Harrisburg picks this up, it's basically ball game. They could just run three or four plays to expire the clock. The River Kings need a stop right now, otherwise they're going home with another L.
Yeah, they do need a stop, and I don't imagine it's an easy or convenient trip back to Cedar Rapids. I don't think they would have taken a bus. There's no direct flight from Harrisburg to Cedar Rapids, so they're likely connecting in Chicago. It's just going to be a long and winding path back. So why not make the stop, get some points, and make it as enjoyable as possible before you head back to the Hawkeye State?
Well, and if I'm from Cedar Rapids, I'm concerned about a 3 o'clock tip-off for tomorrow, trying to watch a national championship game. So I hear you. I'm trying to get out of here as quick as possible. That's just me, though.
Well, we have to thank the league for scheduling this game tonight instead of up against that game tomorrow, because I would imagine viewership in the greater Iowa area would be Caitlin Clark, everyone, River Kings, zero.
Who's this Caitlin Clark person you're speaking of?
I've heard about her. She's like Will Clark's kid or something? No, I'm kidding. She is an amazing basketball player, and she has faced some tremendous competition in the postseason and all throughout the Big Ten season. But I think she might face her biggest foe of them all tomorrow, and that's a 37-0 South Carolina team coached by Dawn Staley.
I like her player intro last night. They introduced her as the player that no one knows, sarcastically.
Fair.
Isaac Hurd in the gun with a chance to put the nail in the coffin. He's got time. Fires close sideline, complete to Gorman, and that will most likely do it.
The chains will move, and Gorman hauled that one in. And a nice job from Hurd on this series. He has been working out of the shadows of his own giant U, which is basically what that goalpost thing is back there. He has been working out of the shadows of his end zone since that squib kick and short return from Marcus Taylor. So a nice job of making something out of nothing. And we talked about it earlier. Now the Stampede in no real rush to do much of anything. Certainly you can't gobble 3 minutes off the game clock. This isn't high school basketball in central Pennsylvania. But you do what you can do to make that clock get down to zero as fast as possible.
Under 3 minutes remaining now, and all Harrisburg has to do is hold on to the football. Hurd with time, takes the sack, brought down by a trio of gray jerseys, and there's a man down for the River Kings.
Dwayne Stewart, we've mentioned him a couple of times tonight, and now he is down on the carpet, and it was Harrisburg Stampede center Casey Pierce finally turning around to signal for someone to come out and check on him. He's going to trot back towards the bench area, which I referenced is behind the respective end zones here, and it's fitting for a team called the Stampede with a bull mascot to have a bit of a corral. What is a River King?
That I couldn't confidently say.
I mean, there's a Disney movie, Davy Crockett. He was king of the river. No, he's king of the wild frontier. There was a guy, I don't even know. We'll have to look that up and report back next week.
Yeah, I'm not the greatest when it comes to wildlife. I didn't watch the Creature Report.
Okay.
What show is that? I couldn't even tell
you. I don't
you.
Even know. Wildcrats?
Something like that.
If it's not narrated by David Attenborough, I don't know. And there's a flag, a tripping foul after the play. The Stampede had lost a yard or two on that play. And then just like that, something silly from the River Kings likely moves the chains and makes it first down all over again.
Clock is paused with a minute 57 remaining. Let's take a quick look ahead at what's up for Harrisburg after today's contest. They're back home next Saturday, 7 p.m. kickoff against the Maryland Eagles.
Ooh. We're going the other way with... That's not helpful.
So they get Gorman with a taunting, and that makes this interesting here. Just for people who are watching the line, I'd say. I'm not talking about the line of scrimmage.
No. Yeah, those folks that run those books, they had this one probably top thing to watch for the night.
A minute 46 and counting in regulation. Third and 11 for Harrisburg trying to ice this contest. Deep ball over the middle, nearly deflected into Gorman's hands. It was underthrown, would have been the fifth touchdown pass of the day for Isaac Hurd. Instead, it's fourth and 11.
He split that double team, and the pass was a little bit underthrown, but you're right, it was tipped, and there was a chance there, and had that fallen into his hands, it would have no doubt been 6 points.
Clock still rolling, a minute and 6 seconds and counting here. Still looking at the schedule as there's a timeout taken here. And it's a 1 minute warning here in Harrisburg. So a further look ahead at the schedule after next Saturday. The Stampede go on the road for a Thursday night contest. And then they'll be back home on April 27th for a 7 p.m. kickoff. You can catch every home game live here on SFBN this season. Mike, this is a great start for the Stampede. They lost their opening day starting quarterback before we even saw a kick on the turf. But Isaac Hurd has played stellar tonight. 4 touchdown passes, a rushing touchdown as well. Just 2 incomplete passes in the second half. He's been brilliant in his first start with the Stampede.
Well, it's certainly not what Coach Bernie Nowotarski thought he'd have tonight from a field general standpoint, but the second lieutenant stepped up and really saw things through tonight, and things to work on, absolutely things to work on. It wasn't a perfect game by any stretch, but he's got to like what he sees as his team's going to be 1-0 coming into the Week 2 game against the Maryland Eagles. And you mentioned SFBN and that you can watch these home games. We want to thank our crew for helping make this game possible tonight as well. A staff of many.
Yeah, Sean Kelly, our director and leader, and a great crew here tonight as on fourth down, this pass intended for Taylor, incomplete, hard hit by Deshaun Schumann, who takes out his frustration on Taylor. Turnover on downs. The River Kings take over with good field position and a chance to score late and have something positive to talk about on their long trip back to Cedar Rapids.
Is it long? It's challenging, but is it long? I've never driven to Iowa.
Can't say I have either.
I ran into Iowa once while I was in Nebraska, but only to say that I was in Iowa, and then I ran right back.
Well, I guess it's all relative, you know.
Yeah. I mean, look, I think a marathon distance is long. I don't want to drive 26.2 miles in my car, let alone run it.
I guess I will drop my bid for the New York City Marathon in November.
You're going to pay those tolls across the Verrazano Narrows Bridge.
I want no part of that. I just saw that article. No, thank you. I've already paid my entry fee. Motion here as Sullivan has returned at the quarterback spot for the River Kings. False start. They'll lose 5 yards. And Mike, I don't understand why they went away from Kaylor Sullivan. He was so effective in the first half for them.
He played very well in the first half, and I mentioned in the start of the second half, I don't think that their issues were because of him. And now it's almost like the coach said, yeah, well, we're not going to win, so go back out and play quarterback again.
Sullivan threw 3 touchdown passes in the first half. He did have 2 turnovers on fumbles, but neither of them were really his fault. High snaps that resulted in a safety and a defensive touchdown for Harrisburg.
Big people were chasing him, too.
Sullivan with time. Pump fakes, throws, end zone incomplete. Flanagan blanketed the whole way. Pena on the coverage.
You don't notice a running clock until it stops running. 5 minutes ago, it was 59 seconds.
Yeah, the final minute of a game. In any sport with a clock, normally the longest. But a late penalty comes in here for pass interference, and I do think that's the right call. Pena was all over the intended man.
He was covering him like a warm blanket. I mean, all of a sudden, a touchdown here could make it a 44-30 game. And I get that the math and the time ratio does not add up, but it's something that Cedar Rapids can build on before their next game.
Sullivan, high snap, hands off to Bright. Clock will roll unless a timeout is called here. The River Kings just with 1 timeout remaining, so Harrisburg very pleased with what they've just seen. And now a late decision to call a timeout, so the River Kings put it on the ground, don't get the touchdown, and then wait 15 seconds to call a timeout.
Upcoming schedule for the Cedar Rapids River Kings, for those of you scoring at home on the 14th. They're taking on the Corpus Christi Tritons. Then it's the Columbus Lions. They're back here against the Stampede in May. Then they host the Stampede in early June, followed by another game against Corpus Christi.
Do you want me to go to a break before the interview?
So with the timeout, Cedar Rapids has another shot on second down.
34 and a half seconds remaining in the fourth. Stay with us after the contest. We'll try to have a word with our player of the game, Isaac Hurd. Sullivan, pump fakes, keeps, dives, end zone, touchdown. Fourth total touchdown today for Sullivan. Three through the air, one on a keeper.
And now they're going to go for two. And his plus-minus ratio is now back on the plus side.
Well, and if you're Sullivan here, I think you're making a strong case for taking every snap at the quarterback position next week.
Have his people call the team's people, have a conversation. So they'll go for two.
Clock is paused with 28 seconds remaining. High snap, Sullivan brings it down. It's a handoff. Good fight by Bright, and is he in? The officials say no. They've got him 6 inches short of pay dirt.
So the Stampede defense holds on that two-point conversion try, and it's been all over but the shouting for the last 6 or 7 minutes. We just need to get through this final 28.1 seconds, and we'll try to have a post-game interview for you. And how about you, Chris? But I'm thinking, I'm not sure how to get back to where my car is.
Well, that's quite the journey. You talk about a marathon.
They asked me for a password when I got to the gate. Like, somehow I'm sneaking into the back lot of this place on a Saturday
well,
afternoon.
I got to tell you, it makes me feel safe knowing that they're right. Not just letting anyone come in.
Right, and I'm glad you guys texted me the password. Otherwise, I'd have been sitting out on McClay Street having a conversation with the security guy trying to hard sell my way in here. Like, no, really, I belong.
Password is chocolate chip cookies.
It is not, but I would love some right now.
I'm just trying to deke some of these fans here into showing up and talking to security.
Start dropping random words. Alpaca.
Onside kick try here for the River Kings, who are out of options.
The last time they did this, it took a while to get there, but the last time they did a squib onside type kick, it resulted in points.
Oh, and did they get it? Did the ball go 10 yards in the air? No signal.
They are saying yes.
Cedar Rapids ball. What a play. Wood on a perfect kick brings it down. And the River Kings with late life.
It takes the big hop from the goal line. And Wood fly. He touched it before the 10. But who's watching replays? He corralled it at about the 8. And the Stampede are trying to make an argument to no avail. But Cedar Rapids will have the ball. 28.1 seconds remaining and a chance to get just a little bit closer to that Harrisburg's 44-point threshold.
Mike, here's what I'm confused about, though.
Yeah.
They went for two.
They did.
It's a 15-point game. Sullivan in the gun.
Math.
High snap. Airs out a deep ball. Incomplete. Verlin Reed, the intended man. Covered well the whole play.
It's going to be second down. A nice job on the coverage by Howard Holton. And Holton celebrated a little bit on that incomplete pass, well, as he should.
Well, if you're Harrisburg here, I'm assuming the strategy, Mike, is just drop back in the coverage. Why let anyone beat you over the top? The River Kings looking for a miracle, down 15 with 22 seconds remaining. Sullivan steps up, pump fakes, he'll run, room to run. Across midfield, he slides down at the 15. No timeouts remaining for the River Kings. The clock pauses with 13.7 seconds remaining for them to reset the chains.
Well, I guess that's what happens, though, when you play deep. You risk giving up a long run. That's the longest run we've seen of the night.
And now the clock rolls. Sullivan end zone. Intercepted, and that'll do it. Pena picks off Sullivan to seal the contest, and Harrisburg will win their first game back in a decade.
Well, that's a fitting ending to a game that was marred by turnovers between the end of the second and early third quarters. And you can see the pass, the perfect throw, just a little bit short, and then ultimately picked off by Emilio Pena, his first pick of the season. And the product out of Division II Shepherd University seals this one for the Stampede.
Fifth turnover tonight by the River Kings. And Coach Nowotarski's defense, the goal tonight was two stops and two turnovers. They far exceeded expectations in that department.
Well, he did a great job. He was very prophetic in what he needed and what he felt his team needed to do for a win. He got that tonight, and then some. Not only did he get the stops and the turnovers, he got points off those turnovers.
And his backup quarterback, Isaac Hurd, brilliant tonight. Five total touchdowns for him. As he goes under center, takes a scamper forward, and that'll do it. The Harrisburg Stampede win their first game back and start 1-0 in the 2024 AIF regular season.
It was a fun one, Chris, that's for sure. It's been a long time since I've watched arena football, and tonight it reminded me why this is such an exciting game. And I hope that the fans that were here tonight enjoyed themselves. I hope they tell their friends and that more people come out for next week's game.
We'll take a quick break and return with an interview with our player of the game, Isaac Hurd. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Harrisburg Stampede Football on SFBN.
You up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom. Tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
It's a final from the Harrisburg Stampede home opener. Stampede 44, River Kings 29. Mike Garland, Chris Markowitz with the call tonight. And we're going to send it down to Chris with our post-game interview. Chris?
Thanks, Mike. I'm here with our player of the game, Isaac Hurd. Isaac, you weren't listed as a starting quarterback coming into this one. Caleb, unfortunately, gets injured during starting lineups being announced. But you come in as the backup. What was your mindset coming into this game as the backup, but then quickly getting the start in this first game here at Harrisburg?
First of all, I'd like to thank Jesus Christ. He's the reason I'm here, and he's the one who kept me ready for this. But first of all, when that happened, oh my gosh, I just got emotional because, you know, you don't want that to happen. You don't want to see that happen to nobody, not even the opposing team. But everybody just kept saying, like, you know, that's the reason you're here. You know, you got to stay ready, and thank the Lord that, you know, we're able to get the win.
Four touchdown passes for you, a touchdown run. That connection you had with Simmons, something special. A lot of long ball touchdowns to him. What'd you like from the connection you had with him through the deep ball?
You know, it's just hard work and practice. We did what we could to make use of the time coming in, excuse me. But he's a fast dude. You know, he can run. So he has the hard part catching the ball. All I have to do is put it up for him, and he's going to make a play.
Your defense, stellar tonight, forced five turnovers, helped you guys turn things around when you were trailing early on. What'd you think from the defensive side of the ball?
It's amazing. It takes a lot of pressure off the offense. Sorry. But that's what we need from them, especially from our first game. We want to see them making stops, getting turnovers. That's huge. So if the offense can do our job, if the defense can do our job, we're going to have a good season.
And final question, thoughts on this atmosphere here in Harrisburg, and what do you think about the season ahead, and how excited are you for being in this community, being a member of the Stampede?
It's amazing. A lot of us are coming from a lot of different places, but we prayed for this. We couldn't wait to get in this environment. So now that we're here, it's pretty beautiful.
Isaac, congrats on the win. Go celebrate with your teammates.
Thank you.
Mike, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Chris. It's been an amazing home opener for the Harrisburg Stampede. Don't forget, back here at the Farm Show Complex next week against the Maryland Eagles. The game time, 7 p.m., and you can catch all the action right here on SFBN. I'm going to be back. Chris Markowitz is going to be back, and we hope you will be back. A big thanks to our SFBN production crew for helping make this possible, and for everyone at the Harrisburg Stampede who brought us in and were so accommodating to kickstart their 2024 season. The final, one last time, the Harrisburg Stampede 44, the Cedar Rapids River Kings 29. Have a good night.